part of we've been doing a campaign just before, slightly earlier, just when the lockdown got over. It's a part of the painter reassurance program. So we did a communication even at that point of time, where the intent was a lot of people needed help, a lot of people needed support. And as a brand, what was I doing for my painters? And I think if you have seen the campaign, in the campaign, we have tried to reassure the one who really matters, which is his wife. So, she's also worried about, for after all this while, he's going back to work and how will he be? You know, the same questions like any one of us would have when we go to an office, for example, back to work after so many months of lockdown. So our idea over there was all the steps that we have taken in terms of, the safety gear and, insurance for the painters and the things that we have done on ground. And this was the starting leg of the painter reassurance campaign. And this current film is an extension of that campaign where in this, we wanted to tell a story again where, we just felt, there's everybody wanting to go back to work. There's nobody who doesn't want to work. And all they need is a bit of help. All they need is a bit of support. And what is the manifestation of that help and support? What does that mean in that person's life? I think that's the story that I wanted to write. And when I wrote this, as a parent, as a father, I understand my responsibilities. And I understand that those who have children and who have come on to hard times, what they must be going through and what they must be, struggling in their mind about how will they fulfill the responsibilities. And like I said, in any time of trouble, I feel that hope is all that we have. And along with hope is a little bit of help. And when they both come together, something really meaningful comes out of it. So I think that was the journey. And like I said, this is a extension of a campaign that started just after lockdown got over. And this is one more story that we wanted to share with our painters, our contractors, and we wanted to talk to them. We wanted to tell, it could be any of their story. It could be one of their story. So we're just trying to amplify by the things that we have done on ground, what does it really materialize like to somebody in somebody's life. Started at the very beginning, I think you forgot to mention one very important campaign. We were the first ones, I think, in the first week of lockdown. Har ghar kuch kehta hai. That's the first campaign, I would say. And why we did that? Very simply put, as a team, we believe that if we stood for homes, what homes meant to people. And when the lockdown happened, home was the one place that made people feel safe. And that was the first campaign that we did during lockdown. And it was very important. And it was a sequel to a very big hit campaign that Piyush had done, in about 12 years back, 10 years back. And such was the impact of that campaign that we had to do one more sequel of that during the lockdown. So we did two versions of Har Ghar Kuch Kehta Hai. And both the versions were just to... people, of course, knew it, what their house was doing to them. People obviously knew what they were discovering in their homes. And it started the journey of our communication, if you ask me, with as an Asian Paints, the brand. And then at a stage when lockdown got over, then came our responsibility to our partners, which is our contractors and painters who are wanting to get back and get assignments. Our customers who were allowed to paint, or wanted a surety from the brand that what were you doing? What steps were you taking? So there were two pronged campaigns, as I told you. One was a painter insurance campaign, and the nosy neighbor was a consumer reassurance campaign done in our brand penalty that we always have done, which is passing on information about what we are doing, but in a way that you want to remember that piece. And again, the insight on nosy neighbor was, each one of us is more curious about what's happening in the other person's house than what's happening in our own house. So we just basically built on that and again, reinforced the fact that when our painters come to your home to paint, this is the new way the painting service will happen. This is what we'll look like. This is what we'll feel like. So that's exactly what our strategy has been. I think to simply put, as a brand partner, as an agency partner to the brand, I think we have been holding the consumer's hand through this journey. There was a stage in life when the lockdown was in place. There was a stage in life when the lockdown got over or started getting lifted, and then came the realities of getting my work done. You know, everybody, somebody's home may have been stuck halfway. Somebody had just started his work, or somebody was wanting to do work. You know, monsoon was coming, you know. So we had to assure our painters, contractors, and our consumers that, you know, you can do the work. And then we did it our way. We did it exactly how Asian Paints creates communication. So like I said, this campaign is if you look at the end, it's about upskilling. I need to upskill the painters to use machine tools, which are basically the way to go on with the new painting jobs that maintain social distancing. Now, upskilling is one part of it. Insurance is another part of it. You know, business leads. So I may want to do a job, but I may not have the access to get business leads. So, you know, and we have a very, and I think probably an Asian Paints spokesperson would be better to answer this question in terms of business leads and, you know, direct. But what we basically understood was that there's a lot of stuff happening. You know, there's a lot of stuff at different levels happening. One is the, you know, upskilling part. Second is the safety gear part. Third is the insurance part. Fourth is the business lead part. Collectively, all this is helping the painter and the contractor community, which is what they need, because I have the access to, you know, source stuff and give it to them, because they are the main people who run. You know, like I keep saying, Ogilvy is run by people, you know. Ogilvy, the agency, is just people. There's no machines here, right? We are the ones, the brains that basically think of solutions into problems. So even here, Asian Paints really has a very amazing relationship. And I've been part of the journey from, you know, Saroj and all the work that we have done in the past. And I've seen, so we have a great equation with our team of people that execute our work, you know. So we've always done work for their, you know, in the past also. And Saroj is one example of that. I remember from the past that we did as a team together. So yeah, that's it. You know, it's been a very great learning experience for us also. So everything has been done for me remotely. I've been sitting in this chair and watching on this computer screen, everything being created across wherever the feasible permission was given to us. Okay. Now let me share some amazing incidents. The first film, we wrote it and Piyush, of course, the man behind Har Ghar Kuch Kehta Hai, is he recorded it in his in house. He's in Goa right now. He recorded it in his cupboard, and then the audio clip came on WhatsApp. Okay, and none of us had a clue how to produce anything because we were absolutely clueless. I mean, none of us had prepared for it. And then our initial plan was to do some, you know, we'll do some stock footage of our old Asian Paints ad. And then we said, no, it doesn't really work because none of these lines go, because what we've written doesn't hold true. So what do we do then? Neha, the director at Coco, is brilliant. Cyrus and me, I took a call to, you know, just get Neha on the call and say, Neha, let's reach out to all the people that we know. You know, I'll reach out to five I know, you reach out to five you know. And let's ask people, are they willing to do something? And then came, you know, some pictures. And if you see the first ad, there is no standard art direction, I would say. Some are just straight pictures, horizontal pictures, videos, you know, no resolution, nothing. People just shot. We created the project in 4 days flat, you know, from the time the audio clip came, the time we briefed people to, and these were all people that we knew, or somebody we knew the person, literally. By the time the second sequel came, we were so deep into learning that we had drawn storyboards and we had sent to, again, real people, actual storyboards saying, this is what you have to do. This is how you have to hold your camera. And this is the speed that you have to shoot at on your phone. So if you look at the second Har Ghar Kuch Kehta Hai, is in craft, I would say, a little better than the first one, because by the time in 1 month we knew what to do. Now come to the painter reassurance campaign, real life husband couple, husband and wife. Okay, so being shot on a phone again remotely, we all hear they have set up the computer and we are guiding them through a computer screen saying this is what you got to do. Okay, the nosy neighbor Manoj Pawa and his wife, again real husband wife, sitting in their own house. And the opposite axis is, of course, shot in Goa. Prasoon Pandey, the magician who created it. Amazing. It was a more than a film exercise. Actually, a great, you know, puzzle piece to put together. So again, great learning for us, you know, because so where and when the market opened, wherever the feasibility was allowed, giving that, you know, the terms and conditions, we had to follow those and work with that. You know, so right now, we have certain pockets in India where we are allowed to shoot with the local people only, with the local talent only. Mm-hmm. But the director can be remote. You know, the agency is remote. So we have to cast from the limited cast talent. So this toy car is a brilliant example because this is a DOP and a director. Fantastic guy, Sachin Pillai. He's incredible. I have just worked with him in the first time in the lockdown. He did the Tata Motors project also, by the way, which was also, I thought was a very nice project. He's a DOP and a director, but he's in Goa, so he's right there. So he had to cast from the talent. Normally, when you cast for any project, the talent is pan-India, wherever it can be from, right? Because you have the accessibility of the entire country. You can go from anywhere, you can get somebody. But here is a challenge. Every single person had to be from the area that was allowed to be. But look what a brilliant cast he's put together.
Yes, and especially the boy has been
brilliant. Brilliant. So I think the credit goes to the team for being able to, and we all have learned, you know, us as creators have learned so much personally. If you ask me, I'm talking from my personal experience, to be, you can create with any kind of limitation as long as your intent and your will is there. You don't have to stop creating. You will only stop creating when your will and your intent goes away. So if your intent is there and your will is there, you will find some kind of a permutation, combination. You will make something happen. Because if your story is amazing, it must be told. If your story is to be shared, it must be shared. You can shoot on a phone camera today, literally, and you can create pieces of work that can be magical. I think I'm not so certain, but I've been told Kochi to a certain extent, Goa to a certain extent, Bangalore to a certain extent, they all have opened up with very, very strict guidelines of minimal crew, safety procedures, you know, all of that. So, I usually a shoot would have 50 people walking around, right? If I understand correctly, probably more. I think they have to be tight as like, literally like skeleton, like 5 or 6 people, 7 people. So that's the way. I think each place has opened up with their own rules and regulation. So as and I've been getting all updates from the Producers Guild saying, you know, and we are obviously remote. Most of the directors in Bombay are shooting remote or wherever else. I think so that's how it is. Lyrics have been written by Nilesh Jain, the guy who wrote my Google Reunion, the same guy. He's a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant writer and writes amazing lyrics. So he's the same guy who wrote Google Reunion, the song for the film. He is with Ogilvy. He works with us. He's a creative guy with us. I put him on the team because once I wrote the film, I thought that it needed the soul. And I couldn't think of anybody else who could do it. And he was brilliant. He wrote it in one attempt. Everybody loved it. Music is my favorite, Abhishek Arora. I've worked a lot with him. He's one of the, again, one of the brightest minds in our industry. The voices of Divya Kumar, a brilliant singer. So, yeah. So we were lucky to, like I said, everybody's working for me. You know, Divya Kumar is recording in his own house. I'm writing the script in my house. Nilesh is writing the lyrics in his own house. Abhishek is recording music in his own studio in his house. So it's all, everyone is, you know, wherever they are, but we all come in together to put together, you know, our effort to make something which makes people feel something, you know, or, you know, like it or enjoy it, or at least enjoy the message in it.